गुड इवनिंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू 6th स्टैंडर्ड ऑनलाइन साइंस क्लास। टुडे ऑनवर्ड्स वी विल स्टार्ट अवर न्यू टर्म विद द बायोलॉजी लेसन। सो इन दिस टर्म टू बायोलॉजी थर्ड लेसन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट। द लेसन नेम इज प्लांट लाइफ। सो लुक एट द पिक्चर। व्हाट इज दिस पिक्चर? दिस इज अ पिक्चर ऑफ a simple plant, isn't it? A picture of a simple plant. You know, it has flowers, it has stem, it has flowers, stem, leaf, branches, and also root. Am I right? It also has a root. Am I right, children? Yes. So we also know that the part above the ground of the plant is called what? Shoot system is called as shoot system, and the part below the ground is called as root system. We have already known this in our lower classes. Am I right, children? Yes. Now we are going to learn about the root system. In the root system, we have already studied that we have the part of the plant below the soil is called a root system. In root system, there are two types of roots. One is called as tap root system, and another one is called as fibrous root system. Tap root system and a fibrous root system. So what is tap root system? Look at the first picture. In the first picture, a main root is present there. Am I right? Yes. So from the main root the small hair like structures arises. Small hair like structures arises from the main root. Am I right, children? So such root system are called as tap root system. Okay, tap root system may be present in spinach. You know spinach. Am I right? Spinach, sunflower, cabbage, rose, mango, banyan. Or some of the plants that have tap root system. You understood, children? So it has a main root. From the main root, a small hair like structures arises, and this is called as tap root system. The next type of the root system is the fibrous root system. Fibrous root system, look at the next picture. What about the next picture? In this next picture, we are able to see the root as a bunch of root is present there. That is called as cluster of roots are present there, isn't it? Cluster of roots are present there. That is such root system are called as what? Fibrous root system. There is no main root. So such root system are called as fibrous root system. Grass, bamboo, sugar cane, wheat, rice, all these plants possess this fibrous root system. Is it clear, children? Now, functions of root system. So what is the main function of this root system? The root system, they grow in the soil and fixes the plant firmly to the ground, right? Isn't it? So it grow in the soil and it grows in the soil and fixes the plant firmly to the ground, and they absorb water from the soil, and plant uses these water and minerals to manufacture food. So they absorb water from the soil and it supplies to other part of the plants. The stem, branches, leaves, everything get water and minerals only from the stem, I mean only from the root, isn't it? So the root absorbs the water and what else it do? It supplies it to other parts of the plant, and because of the water and mineral, the plant is able to prepare its own food. You know that plant prepare the own food by photosynthesis process, right? Now we are going to discuss about the shoot system. So far we have discussed the root system. Now the shoot system, you know that the part of plant which grows above the soil, isn't it? So what are all the things present there? In the stem, we have, by the stem only, the plant is able to get the water and mineral. Okay, the stem transports the water and mineral from the roots to other parts of the, like flowers, buds, leaves, everything gets water through this stem. Okay, the stems have joints called nodes. The stem have joints called nodes, from where the leaves and branches arises. So from the nodes only the leaves and branches arises from here. Okay, so this part is called as node. You understood what are node? And the portion between, from the part of the stem from where the leaves and branches arises, is called node. And the portion between two successive nodes is called as internode. Okay, the space between the two successive nodes is called as internode. Do you understand, children, what are nodes and internodes? That sounds good. Okay, the next about the buds. Okay, the buds that are grows at the terminal of the plant. Terminal of the plant is called as apical bud. Okay, the bud which grows at the terminal of the branches or stem is called to be apical bud. Do you understand what is apical bud? Yes, the next one is buds are not only grows at the terminals, that is apical buds only not present. So there are some other buds that grows at the junction of a leaf or stem. Okay, at the junction of the leaf and the stem. Here is the place where the leaves and the stem meets. Okay, so that is called as junction. From there also some buds will arise and they are called as axillary buds. Do you understood what are axillary buds? Yes. Okay, now this is about the structure of the stems. The buds are of two kinds. They are vegetative as well as florals. Okay, vegetative means from which the vegetable grows, or floral means from which the flower grows. Okay, now the functions of the stem. The stem holds the plant upright and supports the branches, right? Isn't it? So it gives a support to the branches. And the weak stems of climbers, however, cannot perform this function. We will be reading in detail about climbers in the later part of this lesson. And also the next function is the stem bears leaves, buds, flowers and fruits and help to spread them out so that they can function properly, isn't it? It has leaf, flowers, everything it carries, and because of that they grow properly and give the benefits. The stem carries water and minerals from the root to the leaves and distribute the food to other parts. Not only distributing the water and minerals to other part of the plant, it also supplies the food. The leaves, we know that the leaves prepare the food. No, that food is supplied to other parts of the plant through the stem only. So the stem is doing a very important work of transportation. Now the next part of the plant, that is the leaf. We are going to concentrate on the leaf. The leaf is a flat green outgrowth of the stem. Okay, flat green outgrowth of the stem. We know that it arises from the node of the stem. And the wide flat green portion of the leaf is called lamina. So this part, okay, the wide flat green portion, no, this part fully is called as lamina. Is called as lamina. The other name is leaf blade. Lamina or leaf blade. Do you understood what is lamina? Yes, that sounds good. Okay, the next one, the thin portion of the leaf by which it is joined to the stem is called stalk or petiole. Okay, stalk or petiole. So from this portion, no, this here, it joins to the stem, that is called as stalk or petiole. The petiole extends into the leaf blade as the midrib. So it extends into the leaf blade as a midrib. This part is called as midrib. Do you understood what is midrib? Yes. Then the leaf attached to the stem through a slightly expanded area at the base of the petiole is called a leaf base. Is called a leaf base. And from the midrib, no, there arises a small veins. Okay, the thin lines are arising from the veins. These thin lines, they are called as veins. They are called as veins. Veins branches into still smaller. Am I right? still smaller veins, they are called veinlets. These thinner one is called as veins, and the thinnest one is called as veinlets. Do you understand? So why these veins are present? They provide the support to the leaf and also to carry water and minerals and also food. Okay, children. Yes. So this vein, the arrangement of vein on leaf is called venation. Okay, the arrangement, how these veins are arranged in the leaf, that is called venation. This is of two types, the two types of reticulate venation and a parallel venation. Reticulate venation and a parallel venation. What we are seeing in the first figure, no, that is an example for reticulate venation. Reticulate means a reticulum. Reticulum means network. Okay, banyan, China rose, mango, guava, all these type of leaves have this reticulate venation. Similarly, second picture shows us the example of parallel venation. Here is the example of parallel venation. Look at the, have you seen the banana leaf? In banana leaf, the veins are seems to be parallel to each other. They are parallel to each other. The veins are parallel to each other. Am I right, children? Yes. So that is called as parallel venation. Do you understand? So banana, rice, canna, bamboo, grass, all these have parallel venation. Do you understand?